Hi, I'm Dr. Ajani. Thanks for joining me for my top treatments of 2022. We're going to look ahead because last year I did the top treatment of 2021 and it was RF microneedling. And indeed that ended up being the case. This year I have three. I'm going to count them down. Very important video if you are into aesthetics. If you want to know what the best procedures are, what's going to be the hottest trend, not only am I going to tell you the top three, but the number one, I think you may have never heard of before, and it's going to end up being one of the top treatments that quickly. I'm going to go through that one. Each one I'm going to go through, I'm going to tell you briefly what it does and a couple things to watch out for with that treatment. You're going to love this video, so just go click the like button now. I know this is going to be a top video for you. Number three, RF microneedling and fractionated RF. It was number one last year, and I know what devices people are buying because I'm on the forums, I'm talking to people. I'm in about 50 different practices throughout the year. It's the year end, and I know what everyone's asking for. RF microneedling, RF means radio frequency. It's energy delivered through needles in the face. And there's many different devices. There's about six that are in the top. And I'll put a little list right up here of the top six that I am familiar with. You can also get knockoffs of these, so I know home gamers are using them. What they do is the needles go into the skin and give energy. So we all know traditional microneedling, the pen, zzz, it kind of moves around, that goes up about many thousands of RPM and you get just the needles going in. These deliver radio frequency energy. Now radio frequency is electrical. It can be monopolar or bipolar, meaning the energy doesn't go through the whole body but between the needles. So it keeps it safer. And what are people going to see from these? Well, it's important to know that there are two main types of RF microneedling, and I'll say three because the third one is what I use a lot of. Number one will be RF microneedling with insulated tips, meaning there's only energy at the very tip of the needle, not on the shaft of the needle. So the external part of the epidermis, the skin that you see, is unaffected. It only affects the deeper layers. Then you have non-insulated tips. The energy travels up to the skin, so the whole length of the needle has energy. It will affect the outside of the skin. The third type is what I use a lot of, which is a non-needle fractionated RF. Now I'm using the word fractionated. What fractionated means is only a fraction of the skin is treated. A fraction is left untreated, so it helps with the healing process. So in this way, there's less downtime. So these are all fractionated type of procedures. However, with the most popular I use, with no needles going into the skin, it delivers the energy needleless, which is really nice. And the other benefit is that I can affect the surface of the skin and resurface, in a sense, the outside layer to make it smooth, or I can keep the energy deeper, like with the needles. The energy goes through the layers and then affects the change in the deeper layers for collagen and elastin. Or I can do both, the outside of the skin and the inside. The reason that's important is because a lot of times we may only want the surface of the skin, or we might just want the deeper layers, because you might want to attack the fat or you might not want to. You might want to have the outside of the skin resurfaced, brown spots removed, but not the deeper fat gone. And this is the point that so many people are going to ask, do they get rid of natural fat in my face? And the answer is yes, of course they can, and yes they do. So that's what they will do, resurface, smooth the skin. They can help with, of course, pore size. They can get rid of fat. They build collagen, elastin, they tighten. You get a little bit of lift. Lifting is something I'm not going to address today, but if you need a facelift, you need a facelift. But you will get, through the tightening of skin, some lifting. The two things I want you to watch for with this procedure, number one is it doesn't matter what device you're getting. So it should be an FDA approved device. I know a lot of home gamers ask questions about it. The problem with the home gamers, and I travel the world and I see knockoffs in different devices, the energy levels vary. So treatment to treatment, pulse to pulse, so you hit the trigger when the needle goes in, varies. So you sometimes don't know what you're getting. It's just like when you get cheap things from somewhere, no names mentioned. They're just not quite the same. They don't function the same, but in this case, it's your skin and it's your face. So just be careful. So the device matters, but most important, more important than the device, your provider. So have they done 100 or 200 of these? Do they know the physics behind the machine? Are they trying to get your fat? Great, you want your fat gone here. You do not want your fat gone here or here maybe. So it's the settings more than the device. You need a device that's capable of reaching the heat levels that you need, because you can adjust the duration of the heat, what we call pulse duration, the amount of the heat, and I said the word fractionated, the amount or the fraction, the percentage of the skin treated. Very, very complex in a way. I still have a cheat sheet that I use sometimes because I really want to hone in and sometimes get fat, not get fat, affect the epidermis and the more superficial layers. So it's not as easy as it seems. The provider is key. Let's go to number two, and it is CO2 laser. But it's not CO2 laser that you're thinking. It's a light setting CO2 laser. It's the one I had on my Instagram. I put up pictures. I talked about it. I have a YouTube video. If it's not up already, it will be of me talking about it. You can see some of the healing on my face. CO2 laser, unlike the radio frequency that was our number three treatment, CO2 laser is it's over 10,000 nanometer wavelength. So it's going to get water. It's going to ablate. That's why people put the pictures on Instagram, TikTok. They love seeing the skin ablate, burn, if you will. So it's a very powerful laser. You can make surgical cuts with these lasers. Again, we treat a fraction of the skin, so it's less downtime. But what I'm talking about are laser peels, in a sense. And again, remember, this laser is attracted to water, so it will ablate. But if you use lighter settings, low energy, a low percentage of the skin treated, and more treatments so that there's less downtime, less side effects. What are you looking for in side effects? Hyperpigmentation would be a problem. Post-inflammatory PIH, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. And if you see my video on me getting it done, so skin type 4, a little bit darker, when we heal, the body wants to heal. Sometimes the melanin is produced and you get brown spots after, the opposite of what you wanted to go in the treatment to do. So it is complex in that sense, but also prolonged redness. I used to do full ablative CO2, so not treating a fraction of skin, treat the whole skin. It would hammer people. And they would take 3 to 4 weeks, sometimes really 3 months, to get the results and for the skin to settle down, especially sensitive skin, because they get prolonged redness. And you can get scarring. With what I'm talking about, more of a peel, low setting, low energy, low percentage of skin treated, we get less downtime. You don't get the dramatic CO2 results, but the thing is, you can combine this with the radio frequency I talked about as my number three treatment. You can do them same day because the CO2 is going to target the surface of the skin. You're going to need more treatments, so that would be a downfall. The other thing to watch for, it's very user dependent. Once again, you need a great device and you need a great provider, and particularly here, it's a laser. There's a lot more forgiveness in my treatment number three, which was the radio frequency, than this treatment. You can scar the neck. When I had it done, they treated my face, they did the neck. I happened to be in a clinic doing a training. They're like, Rajani, do a CO2. And I had a couple days off after. I just did it. I didn't plan to do it. They did my hands, they did my neck. So I got to experience it all. And I would never treat neck particularly with a full ablative of CO2. You will get scarring, you will get problems. Sure, 4 or 5 patients might work out great, but one may not. 1 in 4 or 5, that's a high percentage, okay? You're talking 20-25%. So that's CO2 laser, so light CO2. So we have RF microneedling or fractionated RF, number three. Number two, CO2 laser. Let's dive into number one. I'm not sure you would have heard a lot about this. This technology existed before, it's now perfected. And what it is, we take the blood, we spin it down, fast. We get the albumin. So that's a clear layer, very much looking like what PRP, some people know what PRP is. We heat that up to form a gel. Then we take another portion of the blood that we spin slowly, and you know PRF. I use it in plasma eyes, plasma brow, plasma sculpt. But we take that slow spin speed because we, and there's no additives. This is 100% natural. There's no heparin, no sodium citrate. There's no plastic plug in the tube. All 100% natural, a person's own blood. Spin it slowly, and what are we getting? Wound healing factors. What happens if you cut yourself? Whether you're 10 years old or you're 100 years old, your body still has the capacity to heal a wound, albeit a little bit less at 100 than at 10. However, it still does because you have mesenchymal stem cells that can differentiate into other type of cells. So you're making new skin cells where you cut yourself because of those mesenchymal stem cells that are also in your blood. Fat is the number one source. A lot of people don't want to harvest fat. Why not just take blood? We have less in the blood, but we're concentrating it. You also have growth factors, and you know this from the skincare I use. I do videos on the skincare I use. People use growth factors when they leave my clinic called Antiage. Those are someone else's bone marrow derived growth factors that are purified and no cells, so it's a topical. In this case, we're taking it from your blood, your own growth factors that are concentrated. And we mix that with the gel. So we mix those two components to form something that has rheologic properties. So those are properties similar to a filler in strength, in volumization. And again, it's 100% natural, inject it back. Where do I use it? I use it mainly cheeks, under eye a lot, the front of the cheek, nasolabial folds. Jawline isn't as impressive with that product for me. The lower face is very impressive. So a lot of females age in the lower face. They don't want fillers. They're scared of migration. They're scared of all the problems that come with fillers. And we can use it in the, what I call thumbprinting, melomental fold, the chin, because a lot of females, and if you're on this channel, I see it in myself too, as we age, this skin gets looser. A lot of people have vertical lip lines. You can use it at the lip border, but we're using the person's own regenerative properties to improve what? The appearance of skin, the glow of skin, the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles, a skin tightening looking effect, and we see an overall rejuvenation. Now, how do I do it? I do this usually in two stages. I do it once, and just like Sculptra, I'm going to do a second session at 4 to 6 weeks. I inject it with a large microcannula, minimal pain. It's your own body stuff, so there's no sting like there might be with an exogenous product or a synthetic product. And then those growth factors, mesenchymal stem cells are injected, they're all yours, and they help your body to, we use the word repair, and I use that because what are you fixing? So I don't mean that in a negative way that we're repairing, but understand, as we grow older, the machinery of the body, the collagen building, the elastin building, the loss of bone, those things accelerate. So what are we repairing? We're improving the health of the environment by concentrating your healing, your wound healing properties, and injecting it back. That's the concept. So obviously I could talk for hours and hours and hours on this, and we teach this. However, it's something you're going to see a lot more of, and I think a lot of people are open to having a treatment that's all natural, that's not fillers. It can be used with fillers. It can be used with biostimulators. If you've had implants or things before, your practitioner, I do it in those cases. Your practitioner, with their comfort level, of course, might be different. But something I've been doing now for over a year, we have lots of data, 3D images, before and after pictures, and I am extremely excited about the results I'm seeing and the patient's satisfaction. So those are the top three. What are your top three? They could be different than mine. Here's a complete playlist up here, things you can do at home, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.